wait no more night. There will be no more sadness, only joy and light, joy and light. Lift your eyes beyond the hills and see the dawn. There is beautiful mercy in the arms of the Holy One. Go in peace, God be with you. Go in peace, be at rest with the saints and the angels. Now you are free. Go in peace. See, the Father is waiting with a robe of white, purest white. Go and feast at his table with the bread of life, bread of life. Lift your heart, rejoice and sing, for you are home. Home at last and forever in the arms of the Holy One. Go in peace, God be with you. Go in peace, be at rest with the saints and the angels. Now you are free. Go in peace. Go in peace. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, our Pauline died with Christ and rose with him to newness of life. May she now share with him his eternal glory.
Please join us in our opening hymn, number 462, On Eagle's Wings.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand, and hold you in the palm of his hands.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant, Pauline, also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in touch. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction. And their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men, indeed, they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. As the sacrificial offering, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Gently you raise me and heal my weary soul. You lead me by pathways of righteousness and truth.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Though I shall wander the valley of death, I fear no evil, for you my side, your rod and your staff, my comfort and my hope.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
A reading from the second book of Timothy. In the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who is coming to judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, I charge you to preach the word, to stay with this task, whether convenient or inconvenient, correcting, reproving, appealing, constantly teaching, and never losing patience. I, for my part, am already being poured out like a libation. The time of my dissolution is near. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, a merited crown awaits me. On that day, the Lord, just judge that he is, will award it to me, and not only to me, but to all who have looked for his appearing with eager longing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Almighty God, up in your mind, on your lips, in your heart, world, the Holy Gospel.
truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On one occasion, Jesus said, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, to you I offer praise. For what you have hidden from the learned and the clever, you have revealed to the merest children. Father, it is true. You have graciously willed it so. Everything has been given over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son but the Father. And no one knows the Father but the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are weary and find life burdensome, and I will refresh you. Take my yoke upon your shoulders and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble of heart. Your souls will find rest, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Welcome. Welcome to all of you who have come to pay your respects and to pray for our Pauline and to be a means of support for Dennis and his family. What we do here today is very important but very holy. So, welcome. On behalf of all of our parishioners at Holy Family Parish and St. Ignatius Loyola Parish, I wish to offer you, all of Pauline's loved ones, our heartfelt sympathies. And please know that we'll be praying for Pauline and for you at all of our weekend masses and for days to come. The gospel today speaks very closely to what the Lord has in store for us. He says, come to me, all you who are weary and find life burdensome. And I will refresh you. Come to me. The words of our Lord speaking gently to each and every one of us. How many times have we been weary, fearful, afraid? And in those times, who is the one who beckons us to come to him but our Lord and Savior? I'd like to suggest that Pauline did this often throughout her life. And so after a life of filled with love for the Lord, our Pauline passed away peacefully at the Canal View Nursing Facility in Hancock this past Monday, where she had been in residence for 3 years. And how long those 3 years were for Dennis and the family. And yet, Dennis was privileged to be with Pauline when she passed away. Dennis had noticed that Pauline's breathing was becoming slower, more shallow. And so he placed his hand on her head and prayed the Our Father with her. And at the conclusion of the Our Father, which he was praying, she took her last breath. That is amazing, my brothers and sisters. It is a moment of holy grace. Pauline, Dennis, and their loved ones to have that moment with her before she left this world and the cares of the world behind. The presence of God is always present to us. especially when we need him the most. And that's why the Lord says to all of us, come to me. Come to me when you'd need me. Pauline was born on November 23rd, 1942, in Lowell, Massachusetts. Her parents were John and Alice Gill. What a gift from God little Pauline was to her family so many years ago. I wonder what was in their minds and hearts when they looked upon their newly born daughter for the very first time. Must have been thankfulness to God for giving them this wonderful little gift, this wonderful little bundle, as we say. Pauline graduated from Lowell High School and then went on for further studies at the University of Boston and achieved a BA degree in English Literature in 1964. Pauline earned a MS degree from Simmons College in 1966. It was while taking the train back and forth to school that she met a young man named Dennis Moore. This would have been way back in February of 1962. Those of us who are married, can we remember the first time we met our husband or wife? Pauline and Dennis remembered. With the Lord's help, they met, and fell in love, and were married at Holy Trinity Church by Father Calaharius on February 19, 1966, in Lowell, Massachusetts. Dennis shared with me that when he met Pauline many years back, he would go out of his way to ride the train home with her from school, even to the point of missing his last class of the day. It was a good choice. Pauline and Dennis moved to St. Louis, Missouri, where Pauline was employed as a librarian at the Regional Veterans Administration Hospital. It was at this time that they began to raise their family. Three wonderful children that would grace the family home. There was Catherine, Matthew, and Christopher. Three little bundles of their own, giving mom and dad a sense of joy in their life. May we always recognize the good that God gives us in our children, especially when they give their parents a little bit of trouble from time to time. Though I'm sure Catherine, Matthew, and Christopher never did that to mom and dad. In 1972, the family moved to Houghton as both mom and dad accepted employment, eventually at Michigan Technological University. Dennis shared with me that he was looking for a change, perhaps. That's when he found this advertisement of a position that was being offered at Michigan Tech, and it seemed as though the fit was perfect. He didn't know where Michigan Tech was, but he and Pauline and their family came north. Pauline became the reference librarian at MTU, and she also earned an MS degree in rhetoric and technological communications. She then went on to receive her PhD in the same field in 1998. Our Pauline was blessed with a strong mind, great intelligence, and was an advocate for literacy and education all through her years. She retired from the library at Michigan Technological University in 2004. And to think that her son is helping us with our service today and their granddaughter is pretty amazing. And our own Dave Desott was with her in the library. It must have been nice to work with Pauline, Dave, all those years. Let's just think about this for a moment. You know, as a student at Michigan Tech, they would have had moments of being greatly stressed, worried, fearful. And yet I can't help but think that Pauline Moore was one of a person of great comfort to those students who needed her help. She was very approachable, very loving, very kind. I can almost see myself, if I were at the students' university, grasping onto her as if she were my own mom. She was that kind of a person. I was available and I was willing to help. You know, my brothers and sisters, the Lord always places all of us in places, positions in this world where we can do the most good. Just think of the good she did for the university, for those students who came to her for help. Pauline enjoyed her faith and was always willing to share her faith with others. She helped to teach the first and second grade class along with a fellow faithful person in the religious faith formation program at St. Anne's in Chassel, preparing young people to receive Holy Communion was a great source that was important to her all through her years. I gotta admit though, I'm glad they left St. Anne's and eventually found themselves here. A little jealousy maybe on my part, but I'm glad they came to St. Ignatius. Pauline was a gifted mother and grandmother and showed great care for her little ones and cared for them with much affection. You know, in our world today especially, we don't always see moms and dads who have such interest in their little ones. But Pauline did. She enjoyed baking bread and working with needlepoint. You know, baking bread, what does that tell us? She enjoyed her family. Baking bread for her family. Pauline found great joy in her family home in Paradise Road near Chassel. The apple orchard was surrounded by a beauty on their property that gave the family much comfort, especially Pauline. May those trees that bloom this spring sing out the praise of God for our Pauline. She was always happy to be a part of our parish of Holy Family, as she found herself the parish that she really enjoyed. She said to her dear husband, Dennis, "It's a place of peace, Holy Family Parish." We were so lucky to have had them there. You know, when I first encountered Pauline and Dennis, I recognized them because I had met them when I was first ordained back in 1984. And for some reason, I started calling Dennis Bernie and Pauline Joanne. And this went on for quite some time. One day, Pauline, in a very gentle way, and Dennis told me, "No, it's not Bernie and Joanne, it's Dennis and Pauline." And she'd come up for communion with her hands out. And from time to time, that old tape in my head would skip a beat, and I'd say, "The body of Christ, Joanne." And she would smile at me with a smile that was just wonderful. That was one of the real gifts that Pauline brought to the world. The sense of comfort, the sense of peace, the sense of longing and love for all of us. And I suspect we're all here today because of that reason. And so, my brothers and sisters, we entrust our Pauline to the gentle care of our Creator, in the blessed hope that our Lord will open his arms and welcome to her. May she find eternal sleep in the presence of our Heavenly Father. Joanne, we will miss you. Pauline, we will miss you. God bless you. Please rise. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save his people, both living and dead.
Our response to the petitions is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pauline, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted into the company of saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pauline, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may all face death with faith, and the conviction that we will see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vision to see God's love in our world, in spite of pain and suffering, separation and loss, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Pauline, that they may find comfort in the belief that her life is now changed, not ended, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. My brothers and sisters, now let us take a moment and in silence thank Almighty God for the gift that our Pauline was to each and every one of us. For all of our prayers, we pray to the Lord. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who have fallen asleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Please join us in our preparation song, number 508, Prayer of St. Francis. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never see
much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive,
and Lord,
in
wash
dying
away my iniquity,
that we're born to eternal life.
Thanks, folks. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of God's holy church.
Be near, O Lord, as we pray for your servant Pauline, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel or be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Pauline, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen,
amen. Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Please kneel or be seated. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
This is Jesus, Emmanuel. God is with us in this sacrament. Come receive him. This is Jesus, Emmanuel. God is with us. outpoured. Royal Paschal Victim, true begotten Son, offered as a ransom by the Holy One. This is Jesus, Emmanuel. God is with us in this sacrament. Come receive him. Adore him. This is Jesus. Jesus, our Lord.
In a bittersweet sort of way, this is a moment of thanksgiving. Thanksgiving that Pauline is now safe and is no longer plagued by Alzheimer's, and that she is now resting peacefully with God. It's time to say thanks to my children, Kathleen, Matthew, Christopher, for not second guessing me with their mother's care and for their constant support. Thank you, Father John, and Deacon Dave, for your support and encouragement during these nearly 6 years of challenge. Thank you also to Holy Family Parish for allowing us to be part of your family and your continuous support. For our friends, the Domino's Group, the Romeos, those retired old men eating out, the Runmans for the Friday morning coffee breaks, and for so many others that were there for us, please accept my sincere thanks. For Dr. Kinzel and Debbie Lorenz, who managed Pauline's health care at Canal View. And a special thanks to the staff at Canal View, the housekeepers, the laundry team, the dietary services, the aides, and the nurses. First in Woodland Haven, and then finally on the third floor, for their constant care, assistance, and compassion. After nearly 3 years as a resident, the staff became an extension of our family. I could not have done it without them. And finally, thank you, Pauline, for 57 years of marriage, for 3 wonderful children, and the loving care that you provided them, for the blueberry buckles and the bread that you baked, for the countless times you read Winnie the Pooh to them and me. I always liked the part about Piglet going after the heffalump, the horrible heffalump, and it turned out to be poor old Winnie with his head stuck in a pot of honey. Oh, so many times I've been there. And so for Pauline, thank you for the Mondays, Saturdays and Sundays, every day the whole year through. Thank you for the fun days, all the number one days, battles to be won days too. I just want to say it. Thank you for each day with you. So, let's say goodbye with a smile, dear. Just for a while, dear, we must part. Don't let this parting upset you. I'll not forget you, sweetheart. We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know that we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies chase those dark clouds away. And I will just say hello to the folks that you know. Tell them that you won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as I watched you go, you were singing this song. We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. I love you, Paniota. Peace be with you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Pauline, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, our Lord. Please be seated. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her once again when the love of Christ conquers all things, including death itself.
Rest in peace until we meet.
again.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Pauline, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Pauline in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with all the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and are with our dear sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. My brothers and sisters, Dennis and his family invite all of us downstairs to our parish hall where lunch will be served right after Mass today. And then once lunch has been completed, we'll make our way to the Chasuble Cemetery for interment. Please rise. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of final rest. Pauline, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Amen.
Please join us in our sending forth song, number 484, Lead Me, Lord.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord. For God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are they, the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled. Blessed are the merciful, for mercy shall be theirs, and the pure in heart shall see their God. Blessed are they whose hunger only holiness can fill, for I say they shall be satisfied. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of